see me, I call them exploiters.
Engineer Adams Cheyune, the director of Steam Investments Company, the firm overseeing the construction, detailed about the steel manufacturing plant. During a site assessment, accompanied by Moses Kamuntu, the Member of Parliament for Rubanda West County and the Director of Kamuntu Iron Ore Investment Limited Company, Engineer Cheyune revealed that the plant is expected to produce an impressive daily output of 5,000 tons of steel. With documentation nearing completion at a remarkable 90%, construction is slated to commence in July.
If it was not for the documents that are required, we would have started immediately, but apparently we're still finalizing with the documents, that is the EIA mostly, and the feasibility study of the area, because initially this project was supposed to be in some other district, but it was shifted because of the presidential pledge, and being that Rwanda has the highest grade of iron ore in Africa. South Africa has 68% grades and Rwanda has 93%.
The plant's operations will require a substantial energy supply with 350 megawatts of electricity on a daily basis to power the machinery. Despite this demand, the engineer remains confident in meeting the energy requirements.
Before we thought of having this project here, we had to check on the programs of infrastructure. So apparently a substation is being built in Rwanda, is about to start, which will be carrying around 80 megawatts. So the 80 megawatts, we expect, we talk to the stakeholders, UETCO, and had pledged to give 70 megawatts to the factory. Though we need more, we need about, this factory needs about 350 megawatts. We are looking at other sources of power, which we are already investigating. That is, there is thermal energy at some place, geothermal in a place called the Ihamba. Ihamba, yeah, I think around there, we expect to build a geothermal plant, which will be able to produce around 200 megawatts, as well as the land we have requested for from the government to put a plant. Adjacent, you saw a hill. That hill, we would like to put wind turbines.
The project engineer also anticipates that the plant will become a major employer, creating approximately 40,000 direct and indirect job opportunities within the region. Leaders highlighted the significance of the plant's impact on local revenue and employment opportunities for both indirect and direct residents. They emphasize that the project aligns with the district's development goals.
Been waiting for many years. You know, most of these countries depend on steel, depend on iron ore. We have countries like America, which were built on iron ore. We see India, South Africa, where we have been. It will be a big milestone for our people.
According to leaders and residents, the project is timely since they had iron ore for long without developed exploitation.
I want to say that it is a huge benefit to the district, as it will attract huge employment of not less than 5,000. I have interacted with the team in detail, and I'm told that it will attract employment of not less than 5,000 of our youth and other interested or qualifying persons.
Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.